Speaking freedom. Speaking freedom. Giving you the answers to be free. Be free. Be free. 'Cause we're speaking freedom. Okay, so I just did one video that kind of was, it was not all over the place, but I did talk about my dream that I had some not so on topic points within it. That's the best way to say that. So I am leaving the VA medical center. Let me put some hand sanitizer on my hands before I start touching too many things. Wipe down my steering wheel with the hand sanitizer that's on my hands, and then make sure it's all over my hands to wipe down my hands. So this video is going to be uncomfortable for those that it's uncomfortable for. And for me, it is what it is, nigga. It is what it is. So, I'm kind of left speechless a little bit because, honestly, I hate, clicker or ticket. I'm kind of left speechless because this next video, this video right here, is about, I want to say it's about relationships, building relationships, establishing relationships. But there is not a great basis or pre-existing narrative to what I'm going to talk on. Because I really just wanted to say, I wonder if the approval rating for who I'm dating or would like to date has gone down. Somebody think that the situation is toxic. Is what I've gathered thus far. And it made me ask whether they believe that the situation overall is toxic or the circumstances in which the situation presents itself is toxic. And it makes me wonder who is putting in for the pre-qualification background screening, because at this point in my life, based on my experiences and whatnot, the choice on deciding who to entertain when it comes to considering dating someone has changed. And it seems as though there may be some, as I pass Tyler Perry's studio, that are inquisitive about the application process. And seems like there are some people submitting the pre-qualification checklist. And I'm okay with that. I just want to let it to be known, and I may not post this video immediately, I may post it a little later on, but truth of the matter is that I'm really on the market in an off the market type of way. It's like one of those deals that can only be done if you know somebody who knows somebody who know the person that, you know what I'm saying, is trying to make the deal. So I mean, I think that the person that has been inquiring thus far is sincere, I hope, and intentions. However, I've always felt like, even with the last person that I dealt with, listen, until I'm married, I'm single. Now, I wear this ring that I went and purchased that is brown and gold because I believe that I am brown gold. Like, what I have inside of me is worth gold, and my brown skin is worth billions. So I wear this ring not because I'm committed to anyone, but because I'm more so committed to what I believe and the concept of something. So even though I handle myself as though I'm taken, even though I be talking about my husband and shit, like, really honestly, the person that I love and I see as my best friend in the whole wide world, that really can do no wrong even when he pisses me off, it is who he is. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not gonna change whether, and this is why I always kind of give the disclaimer, like, even if me and this person does not work out, even if all the wall art and the pictures come down, even if everything is changed around and we move and go different directions than what we have planned thus far, I still don't want him to be without. I still don't want nothing bad to happen to him. Like, but I think that the perception is that this person could potentially be toxic, abusive even. And it really makes me reflect on several things, like the work permit that was given, and some of the things that were reflected in some of the spoken narrative of how evil this person really is, or how this person comes off as, and living with the person. And this is why I always say, like, I don't want my view and the narrative in which I believe that we're building to be based on some bullshit. So I try my best to not get caught up in the hype, and because I really know that who I perceive a person to be from a distance may be something different than who they actually are in person. And the nicest and sweetest people can also be the meanest and most hurtful. However, I also know that different people bring out different aspects and parameters of a person. So somebody that may have been able to frustrate and bring a person to their ultimate low in another situation, that same person could be a totally different person. Now, of course, it takes a lot of healing for a person to change. It takes a lot of self-reflection for a person to change and own their bad just as much as they own their good. And I'm saying all this way because I believe in this person. Like, I want to believe in this person, whether it is for me to be with this person, or if I am preparing this person to be with someone else that is more suitable for this person than I am myself. And I'm okay with all that. Like, a lot of people be like, well, I don't want to build build a man up to be with somebody else. Shit, I'm trying to build all men up to be with whoever they're called to be with. Because guess what? If this person isn't supposed to be with me and I'm holding them up, then the person that's supposed to be with me is going to end up being with somebody else. And neither one of us will, you know what I'm saying, get what God has for us based on the narrative that God created. So personally, if I can build a man up to be the best version of himself for his wife or the person that he's supposed to be with, then I'm all for it. You know why? Because one man built up to his best version of himself will build up other men. One man that has been fed, that has been groomed, that has been that has learned from a woman, from a person who has an actual life-producing womb, will impact other people that he's around and the people that God, you know what I'm saying, placed in his stratosphere. So building up a man for somebody else does not make me feel no type of way. It just means that I have contributed to the growth of society in a major way. Like, I pray that I'm able to build up men in order for them to have their wives and never hurt their wives, never diminish their wives' trust, never make them their wives question themselves. Because honestly, right now, for the most part, the person that has pursued me the most, sometimes I don't even believe half the shit that he be talking about is going on, or the shit that he be talking, because the way his job is set up, he has to tell a lot of fibs in order to protect what it is that he is working on. And I get it, I understand it. The only problem that I've ever had is that you are creating a narrative to where people won't trust you when you say something. The only, and really this is to be the narrative anyways, to not trust the person word, but trust what they follow through on, trust their actions, trust the things that they are able to do to show and prove who they are, the intentions of their heart, and everything else involved with being the best version of themselves that they can be, truly and honestly. Because anybody can say whatever they want to in order to get you on the hook and reel you in and toss you to and fro and play with you and have no intentions on really building with you, no intentions on really having a relationship with you, no intentions for anything. And for myself, I've gotten to a point to where I realized that a long time ago, you know, like, that's why I'm skeptical of when people say all the right things and then their actions don't line up. But when somebody says the things and does the things that align with that, what they say, and they do everything in their power to make sure that you are okay from whatever the parameters are set, then it's a little bit different for me. Now I'm just talking at this point. But I am taking applications. Because the real 5-year mark is quickly approaching. And I don't want to say it's slowly approaching because I want some dick. But it is approaching. And just because I say I want some dick, or just because that five, and the reason why the real 5 years versus the 5 years from the time I stopped having sex, because I didn't take the person serious until a year after I was not having sex no more. And really, still, I take the person at face value. So, all right, if that's what you say, okay. But we'll see. You know what I'm saying? And if it all adds up and everything checks out, then we on our merry little way. The thing is that if I marry somebody and I don't know that they're toxic, or I don't know that it's going to, like, I can't perceive. Look, I can perceive a lot of shit, but I cannot interject what I want shit to be when it comes to love. So, you know, like, love is a is blinding. But not if you take and approach love from a different type of understanding. Like, okay, I love you, but I'm not going to be blinded by your foolishness. So until you show me the truth of what you're saying, then I'm open to it, but I'm not holding myself, you know what I'm saying, back for it. At this point, I use my children as an excuse not to date. I really don't have time to date because of having children, and I don't have time to make time to be trying to leave my children at home so I can go and be trying to fuck on something or be trying to get to know somebody. Like, I need to get to know you before I get to know you. Like, I need to be familiar with you and everything about you before it's time for me to meet you. And really, honestly, that's really limited to being able to correspond and get to know somebody through social media, or get to know aspects of a person, because people post what they want you to see on social media. So there's a lot of things that could be missing. So that's why I always talk about, I don't want to get caught up in the fog of who I think somebody is because of what they want me to see. I want to see who you really are. So I don't want to fall in love with the facade. I want to get to know your facade. I want to get to know as much as I can. And then I want to come around you so I can see if that shit add up and you really who you say you are. Because people lie all the time, B. But not just that, you know, I'm very protective of myself. So the things that I used to be okay with, I am not okay with now. The things that I used to overlook, I do not overlook now. This nigga's on thin ice and don't nobody really know it but him and I, because I don't tell nobody everything that we go through or going through or growing through. And I say that and it sounds crazy because I never spent time with this person. But I have faith in, you know what I'm saying, the possibility of not on his potential. I like him for who he is currently. All the bullshit, all the drama, all the extra shit, even the baby mama, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm okay with everything based on what it is now, not based on what the possibility could be. But when I say possibility, the possibility of him and I, you know what I'm saying? That's what I look at. Okay, this is what this could build to be. But I'm not about to sacrifice myself for no money, for no fame, for no name, for nothing. But I'm also not going to play myself and just, you know what I'm saying, throw something away. I'm not going to throw myself away, more importantly. But lately, the vibe is being that I need to run while I can and have the chance, because, and like I've already said, that maybe the things have happened the way they've happened because God is like, no, don't do that. That is not the best move for you. However, I don't know, to be the truth, to tell the truth and be honest. I'm just trying to be the best version of me. I'm prepared to be single forever if I can get some dick. I don't mind being single or whatever, but let me stop playing. I'm not playing, but let me stop playing. I look forward to whatever God has for me. I'm not gonna force my way. I'm not gonna manipulate nobody. I'm not gonna make nobody buy my time or buy a relationship with me. I like to feel people authentically and genuinely. And the discernment that I have may not be able to project, protect, or, you know what I'm saying, play on the aspect of love. But the deep soul of a person is what I'm into. And all that surface level shit is neither here nor there. But I refuse to be with anybody that's abusive on any level. So, yeah. I think that's all I got to say about that. It ain't really much more to say, you know what I'm saying? Like, whatever God got for me is going to be for me regardless. And my only thing is that I don't want to be divorced 2, 3, 4, 5 times before I find the one. So I'm willing to take my time to establish the right relationship with the right person so that we can get the right results. Not as far as what we can do together, but who we... Oh, it's a bluebird. Oh, it's a bluebird. I should go back and try to get a picture of it. That's a sign to me. Not, you know what I'm saying, on what we can do when we get together, but who we can become being together, working together. And again, I'm never talking about materialistic type of things. I'm talking about us becoming the best versions of ourselves. And then those best versions coming together and God developing something that changes the world through us because we've already worked on ourselves. That's where my mind is at. Now, whether or not that shit is going to work out the way that I want it to work out, I don't know. But I'm not going to force my hand either. So, again, I am taking the pre-qualification letters. For the dating applications, you got to be pre-qualified, and that can mean several things to several people, but I'm open in a closed way.
Speaking Freedom presents Good Head Group, providing advanced spiritual studies and personal developmental insight, brought to you by Love Gang and Speaking Freedom. We look forward to helping you grow in all the areas of your life. We hope that you find all the information needed for your growth. God bless. Please listen to all disclaimers provided. If you are currently under physician's care, please maintain that relationship. This is not intended to stop your current treatment plan. If you need physician care, please seek out medical attention. Please note, all results are based on the individual's ability to adapt and adjust to any given environment and situation. We are not responsible for your results at Speaking Freedom. The Life Enhancement Coaches at Speaking Freedom provide information to help you grow. You are responsible for maintaining that growth, taking on and then applying the information to your individual life as you deem needed and necessary. This may contain and explain explicit content. Please use parental discretion. For best results, you will need an open mind, the ability to research, and a balanced lifestyle.
Please join us daily for your inspiration and motivation.
We have the entire world to offer you at your fingertips. Your Life Enhancement Coaching Specialist. Thank you for choosing us to assist you in accomplishing your personal and professional goals. And have a beautiful day. In love, we trust. This is brought to you by Good Head Group, Love Gang, and Speaking Freedom. We thank God for you, and we love you.
Hi, I'm Kaci. Dr. Kaci, to be exact, owner of Speaking Freedom LLC, Love Gang, and Good Head Group LLC. I am also a certified life coach and host of Speaking Freedom Radio and TV. Although I have recently became an ordained minister, please be aware that I am still me, raw and uncut the way God made me and allowed life to shape me. I pray and expect God to use me for people who can receive the way I communicate, as well as my delivery. I am not for those who are already saved, religious, or super deep. I am for the leaders, hustlers, and street influencers around the world, including pimps, killers, drug dealers, and working girls. I am sharing my experiences and perspective to help someone be inspired to be better. And for those who can identify with the various aspects of my mindset. My mindset alone does not determine the status of any active connections or current relationships that have not already been specifically addressed. Additionally, these recordings should not be taken personally if I have not already spoken to you about the topic or expressed that I have an issue. These recordings are a part of my life's work to document my experience, perspective, and to see how life has shaped me. My plan in using my stories publicly and socially is to encourage growth in those who can identify with the experiences and find inspiration in my life to heal and overcome the path that they've been set on, no matter what they face, as according to the purpose of their soul, until healing takes place. Despite the experiences that I may have had with any person, sometimes known and unknown, I hold no grudges, no hate, no bitterness, or any other ill feelings against anyone. I pray that your life is whole and very fruitful. I forgive you, as I hope that you forgive me if I have wronged you or anyone that you know or anyone who listens to me. I pray that you have peace and extend the same grace to others. I have love for everyone, especially on a human level, despite flaws or experiences. But that doesn't mean that I will associate or be close to every human that I know or meet. I've experienced a very eventful life and truly believe that my mindset and story based on experiences could help those who identify with how I think and are looking for inspiration to grow further, go beyond hurt, and be great. I pray that these recordings bless you and your soul in every way and whatever way God has intended. Sending love and light to all. Thanks for listening. Achieve your dreams.